This place has seen better days.
Revelio. 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 Brilliant.
you get on with those tasks?
Madam Kagawa, I completed the list of tasks you assigned.
Wonderful. I trust you became more familiar with your broom through the process?
Yes, Professor.
That's good to hear. Keep it up, and perhaps one day you'll have a spot on the Quidditch team. If Black ever permits Quidditch again. Well, with those tasks out of the way, let us get started. Glacius. Pay attention to your wand work. Well done. I'd recommend that you practice your new spell here in my office before taking it out into the world.
Revelio.
Dark is always the best time to strike. If nature has...
Can't figure out why there's such a fuss over poaching. There's enough dumb beasts for everyone.
One of the little bastards scratched me. I'll let him live, champ.
Trocus Totalus.
I'm sure it'd be harder to kill a moon calf.
Protego.
What have you done? You'll have to fight eventually.
Confringo. One less poacher in the wizarding world.
Over with, shall we? I have things to do. He's weak.
It's you. You cost us our ransom. We had to...
Confringo!
Stupid one.
You insolent crap!
Accio! Depulso!
Falcon Dringo! Defender! Potato! Confringo!
Ugh. Shame you're so foul.
I believe you are ready to learn Arresto Momentum, the slowing charm. It allows you to freeze objects or people in midair. Simply complete a few tasks and then come and see me.
Hogsmeade, here I come.
Because you know Dumas.
Take your time looking about. Plenty of wonderful books to stoke a curious mind like yours.
Now I can conjure a breeding pen in the room. Best get back to Deke with the Thestrals.
Let me know if there's anything else I can do to help.
Revelio.
What do we have here? A demiguise. Mine now, demiguise.
Chinese chomping.
I told you not to go down that path.
Miss Peck from Rude and Peck said a customer lost a deericle around here. I know we're not supposed to go down there. I just thought...
Come in! Sorry if there's a smell. New batch of toad hide. Earn a reward. Now, what sorts of beast byproducts might you be looking to acquire?
Finally! I'll have enough for that wind wisp. Ah, well, not meant to be. Also, I may have knocked over a dustbin back there.
Never mind, I'll fix it, as always.
I'll not mind seeing you here again. Consider yourself welcome.
out of the new sock, so if your feet are smelly, you'll have to work it out for yourself. Plenty for your perusal today. Take your time. I'd say that looks as if it was made for you. I'd say that looks as if it was made for you. I'd say that looks as if it was made for you. I suspect you have a sharp eye for fashion. Be sure to stop by whenever you're about.
Alohomora. Incendio. Lumos. Revelio. I've rescued the Thestrals and bought the spellcraft for the pen.
Excellent. Now, to breed your Thestrals, simply release them into the same vivarium in which you conjure the pen. Then use the pen to start the process. Come and see Deke when you're finished.
I shall. I wonder where I should conjure their pen.
Never grows tired of the room's surprises. We now have the perfect place for those Thestrals. Please let Deke know once you've bred them.
Thank you. Scorpio. Wingardium Leviosa. Compulso. Accio. Wingardium Leviosa.
You're doing well breeding beasts. Perhaps you should try with the Thestrals you rescued.
Pay attention. Sharp has plenty of use.
Aloha, Mora.
Have any Valerian sprigs?
Muggle school is so dull compared to Hogwarts.
I remind you that you are studying at Hogwarts and not the Three Broomsticks. You'll never become an aura at this rate. So get your head out of your butterbeer and into a bastard's wizarding book, for Merlin's sake.
You'll never believe what I've learned.
What did you discover in the spellbook we found in the scriptorium?
Salazar Slytherin's spellbook was a little difficult to interpret, but fascinating. Evidently, he encouraged teaching dark magic at Hogwarts. Neither the Imperious Curse nor the Killing Curse was unforgivable during his time. He believed students should be prepared to use dark magic when necessary, not to fear it. That's why we had to use Crucio to gain access to the scriptorium. He didn't want his knowledge shared with anyone who was afraid of the power of dark magic.
It was hard to do, but casting Crucio was our only option.
And I'm glad we did it, because in the spellbook I also found something else. References to a lost relic, which, from what I can tell, grants the holder the power to reverse dark magic curses.
And you think this relic might be able to save Anne?
Precisely. I plan to search for this relic. But I don't think we should tell anyone. Especially Ominous. He wouldn't understand.
We need to tell him. He's the reason we found the book, and he deserves to know what you've learned.
You've seen how he frets about the dark arts. I promise I'll tell him when I found the relic. When I know more, I shall send an owl. And don't feel sorry for Ominous. Keeping this to ourselves for now is for his own good.
I'll decide what's for my own good.
Ominous, we were just about to get some air. Care to join?
You're a liar, Sebastian. I heard everything. You swore you'd never engage in anything to do with dark magic again.
No, I didn't. I said I understood you wanting that. I'd never swear to give up on finding a cure for Anne.
You don't know when to stop, do you?
I know when not to stop. Leave this alone, Ominous. I'll be on my way.
I am not letting this go.
Ominous, Sebastian meant well.
I appreciate you telling Sebastian not to keep this from me, but going after that relic is not a good idea. Sebastian doesn't even realize it, but he's as irresponsible and reckless now as his parents were years ago. It's why they died.
I knew his parents died, but I never heard what happened.
Mr. and Mrs. Sallow were professors. Spent nearly every waking moment in the cellar library. Noses buried in books. Anne and Sebastian were upstairs when it happened. They heard a sudden crash and ran downstairs, but it was too late. Their parents had crumpled to the floor. A defect with the lamp in the cellar caused the room to fill with an undetectable toxin. Sebastian and Anne were helpless. They had no magic yet.
What a horrible story.
It is. That's why I can't understand Sebastian's recklessness. I've practically lost Anne. I cannot lose Sebastian too. Please avoid anything to do with that spellbook.
Some references Sebastian mentioned in the book do worry me.
I'm glad you understand. I hope Sebastian pursues this no further. But if you think he might, please let me know. It would mean a lot.
I can't remember the last time Sebastian locked with you.
Aloha, Mora.
What do we have here? A den? Mind now, demiguys.
Who would have thought someone as young as me could save my uncle's life?
Alohomora. Revelio. Alohomora. Levioso! Accio! Alohomora. Alohomora. Levioso.
The book Professor Weasley asked me to find should be around here somewhere.
Looking for the book Intermediate Transfiguration.
Professor Weasley asked me to, get something from that book. May I have it?
Did she now? I'll give you this book if you humor me by answering a few questions from my quiz.
Quiz?
Some people call bits of knowledge trivia. I would argue that no knowledge is trivial. Hence, I have created a small quiz just for fun, focusing mainly on the lore of the Wizarding World. None of the other students will try it, no matter how many times I ask. They all say they have enough with schoolwork. Ugh, they don't value knowledge the way I do. Surely you're interested. I'll even start you off with a few of my easiest questions.
If that's the only way I can convince you to give me that book, then let's get it over with.
Splendid! Just a few questions, and then I'll hand over this book. Let us begin. Before the invention of the Golden Snitch, which magical creature was used in a game of Quidditch?
The Golden Snidget.
Correct! The Snidget was first introduced to Quidditch in 1269 by a wizard named Barbarous Bragg. Sadly, they're thought to be extinct. Next question. Which potion is commonly referred to as liquid luck?
Felix Felicis.
Well done. Since it makes the drinker temporarily lucky, Felix Felicis is a banned substance in all organized competitions. The tale of the three brothers involves which magical artifacts?
The Deathly Hallows.
Correct. According to Beedle the Bard, the Deathly Hallows consists of the Elder Wand, the Resurrection Stone, and the Cloak of Invisibility. Which ball in Quidditch is the largest?
The Snitch.
I'm sorry, but the correct answer was the Quaffle. When a chaser throws the Quaffle through one of three hoops in a Quidditch match, their team is awarded 10 points. True or false? Polyjuice potion allows the drinker to change species.
False.
Correct. While Polyjuice potion can be used to change things such as age or race, it cannot be used to change species. Well, I suppose this has gone on long enough. I'll put the book back on the pedestal now. If you're inclined to test your knowledge again, I have plenty more questions I could ask you. And I won't be giving you any more easy questions either. The next ones will be more difficult.
I'm sorry. I don't have time for a quiz at the moment.
Let me know if you change your mind. I put the book back on the pedestal for you.
Revelio ought to make quick work of this.
Revelio!
Professor Weasley's tasks are complete. I should attend Transfiguration.
Lumos. Revelio.
Reading can be as magical as any spell. Why can't students?
It's a relief to finally have an answer as to why that portrait was empty. I heard Professor Weasley transfigured the book with all her test answers into an owl to stop...
Making owls are a bit too literally, if you ask me.
Beautiful.
Goodness. Settle down, settle down. Transfiguration, as you may be weary of hearing me say, is an exact science that can take a lifetime to master. But we needn't be daunted. Almost anything can be transformed if you can just perceive the potential within it. As I see in all of you, tremendous witches and wizards, every one of you. Or it could just be my eyesight. Now, you all know what to do. Beautifully done. Class is dismissed. And remember, now is not the time to ease off your studying. OWLs will be here before you know it.
You wanted to discuss my progress so far this term, Professor.
I did. You seem to have had no trouble in getting up to speed. And frankly, excelling in your schoolwork this year.
Thank you, Professor. The extra assignments have been helpful.
As I suspected they would be. Now, it seems you've been making good use of the opportunities presented by your field guide. Of course, the guide isn't the only measure of success. I've heard that you can brew an impressive Edurus potion. Hopefully you won't need it anytime soon, but it is a valuable potion to have when it is needed.
Thank you, Professor.
I will say I'm especially impressed with all you've accomplished in light of the rumors of your extracurricular activities. Were your meetings with Professor Black's house elf and exploration of various caves down by the lake connected in any way to Professor Fig?
Not at all. I was, intrigued by stories of a giant squid and wanted to learn more. I encountered Scrope, who seemed delighted to share what he knew.
I see. I admire your penchant for learning, but do remember that your classwork and field guide are designed to educate you thoroughly. It'll be the end of the year in no time, and you'll want to be well prepared for your OWLs. I'll provide a final assessment at that time to ensure that you're ready for your exams. Until then, well done. You are dismissed. If you wish to practice the spell you just learned, the training dummy is available.
Since our visit to Feldcroft, something dawned on me about the triptych. Meet me at the Overlook, just north of the Forbidden Forest, and I'll explain.
My plan with the helmet failed, but I have another idea. I think we may be able to find what we need at a goblin mine south of Hogwarts. Meet me there, and bring someone who speaks gobbledygook.
I remember Armeet mentioning something about gobbledygook.